So we have understood to make our life simple, we take charge to be continuous, not as discrete points. So here, suppose if we take this wire has a charge. Definitely charges on this wire must be discrete, but since these are so near to each other, we can take them continuous. Similarly, on this piece of paper in 2D, the charges are so near that we can take this small element as continuous charge element. Similarly, on this volume here, we take a very small volume and consider that in this small volume charges are continuous. So for understanding this, we define densities. So since this is a line, so we define linear density. This is area, so we define surface density, and this is volume. This is here we define the volume density. First, let us go to the understanding of density. So why do we use density? So in classical mechanics, when we take any substance, let us say ice, so instead of measuring ice every time, so what we define? Density of water. So that means if we take 1 kilogram of this, what would the volume that will occupy? Or if we take this much volume, let us say 1 liter of water, that how much weight? So we define density. Similarly, in the electric field we define density, but here instead of one type of density, which is volume, where we divide by volume, we have three different type of density: linear charge density, surface charge density, and volume charge density. Okay, three different type of density. So how can we do this? See, in the first case we took that charge to be continuous, this charge to be continuous on this line, and we take a very small element. What is that element? Delta L. So please remember, when we move to this type of mechanics, we take very small elements. So suppose there is a line, very big line, and when we take very small piece of this line, so that is called very small element of this line, delta L, and whole is L, complete line is L. The small element of this line is delta L. That means it is very small, very very small, and total charge on this line was Q, and very small charge on this element is delta Q. The small charge on this line is delta Q, total charge is Q, total line is L, and this very small element is delta L. So for line, this density lambda, this is linear charge density, is defined as delta Q by delta L. Delta Q by delta L. So why I have defined linear charge density? I think that linear charge density lambda is to be defined first, then surface, then volume. So they have started with surface charge density. They have defined the surface charge density sigma. Delta Q, similarly, this is total surface, there is a small element, this is delta S, whole area is S, yani S means surface, this small area is very small surface area, this is whole surface area, whole charge is Q, this small charge is delta Q. So when we define this surface charge density, this is represented by sigma, linear charge density by lambda, this is sigma, this is rho. So these are the symbols of this: linear charge density lambda, surface charge density sigma, this is rho. So now when we define this surface charge density, so this delta Q upon delta S. So here we see that this is surface charge density, and when we move little bit further, here we see this linear charge density lambda, delta Q by delta L we just defined, and we see for volume, this is simply delta Q upon delta V. So this is a small volume, this has very small charge, delta Q, and this is delta volume. So this is rho, this is volume charge density, simply called charge density or volume charge density. This is linear charge density lambda, and this is surface charge density. So we have three different type of charge density, and from here you can see that delta Q is rho delta V. Delta Q is equal to, from here, sigma delta S. From this you can see delta Q is lambda delta E. So this is line charge, this is surface charge, this is volume charge. These are simple equations. We are doing nothing, just dividing the small charge delta Q by either by surface or by volume or by line element. Okay, so this is the concept of charge density, where delta Q is the charge induced macroscopically. Small volume element delta V includes a large number of microscopic charge. So what they are trying to say is that delta Q, though you say that delta Q is very small, you say it is very small, it is almost zero, but macroscopically, that means you see it is very small, but at microscopic level this has very large number of charges. That's why you simplified this. So let us say if there is a volume and it has a 1 coulomb of charge, and you divide it to very small pieces. So this volume has a small charge delta Q is, let us say, 1 micro coulomb. So for you this is very small, but even in this micro coulomb, 1 micro coulomb, you know there are large number of microscope charge constituents, large number of charge constituents. And what are the units for these charge densities? See, for this volume charge, this is charge coulomb, and this volume is meter cube. So coulomb per meter cube, this is charge coulomb, and L is meter. So linear charge density is coulomb per meter, surface charge density is coulomb, and this area is meter square. So surface charge density has a unit of coulomb per meter square, linear charge density has a unit of coulomb per meter, and volume charge density has a unit of coulomb per meter cube. So these are the unit of these charge densities, these charge densities. So now let us move little bit further. So the density, this is very similar to density of liquid. We are referring to a macroscopic density. We regard it as a continuous fluid and ignore its discrete molecular constitution. Similar as we forget about different atoms or molecules of any fluid, and we think of only density. Similarly, here we are thinking charge as a density. Charge as a density, we are forgetting what the individual electrons or protons are doing. So we are thinking as a continuous distribution. So in this way, we are trying to solve our many problems. And in the next parts, we are going to take these equations, take these densities to solve our problems. Okay, thank you very much.